Georgi Zhukov, one of the most famous and titled commanders of the Second World War. When Germany attacked the Soviet Union, Zhukov was the chief of the general staff, and it was he who was entrusted with the task of rebuffing Hitler's army. But the counterattacks carried out led to the defeat of the Red Army. As a result of miscalculations, whole divisions appeared in the encirclement. In 1942, Zhukov commanded the Western Front. Marshal of Victory carried out continuous offensives, which ended in defeat. The total losses in the Rzhev-Yazemsky operation alone amounted to 777,000 people. Unheard of victims did not stop Zhukov, so the commander's nickname Hearse or Butcher quickly spread among ordinary soldiers. In the summer of 1944, Zhukov coordinated the actions of the 1st and 2nd Belarusian fronts. Most of the laurels for the successful Bagration operation, thanks to which Belarusia was liberated from the Nazis, was appropriated by Zhukov, pushing other commanders into the shadow. In particular, the commander of the 1st Belarusian front, Marshal Konstantin Rokossovsky. The culmination of Zhukov's fame was an attack on Berlin. Despite the fact that the defeat of Germany was already a matter of time, the Marshal of Victory did not reckon with any victims. In the Berlin operation, he daily lost more than 15,000 soldiers, almost 90 tanks and 40 aircraft, all in order to enter Berlin before the Allies. According to the official, clearly underestimated data, in the Berlin operation, the Red Army lost 352,000 people killed and captured. After the end of World War II, Zhukov was the commandant of the Soviet occupation zone in Germany. A year later, through war crimes and looting, he was removed from this post. It also concealed that after World War II, Zhukov was involved in a number of other crimes. In 1954, he led the 45,000th military exercises at the Totsky training ground. To study the capabilities of the army in a nuclear war, they secretly used an atomic bomb. Due to the complete secrecy of the special operation, no one yet knows how many soldiers died or suffered as a result of that test. In 1957, Georgi Zhukov, the communists themselves for mistakes and perversions, removed from the post of Minister of Defense. The personality cult of the marshal began to be created later, already under Brezhnev. Remember, Georgi Zhukov is an ambiguous and mythologized figure. The cult of his personality, which was created in the USSR and is produced in modern Russia, is far from historical truth. And the commander himself was turned into a bright label, an instrument of totalitarian propaganda. We will heed that we owe the victory over Nazism to millions of soldiers and officers, hundreds of thousands of whom still lie in nameless graves. In such circumstances, there can be no victory marshal, and it's hardly ethical to associate it with any particular name.